What's up, guys? This is Manoj Oprani. I welcome you all on behalf of the ADPDA world. So, this is gonna be the video presentation in which I'm gonna discuss with you about the kind of basic formula, the kind of formulas that will be used, the kind of concepts relating to those formulas that are really important for you to understand and remember in order to ensure that you are able to solve any amount of questions, that any number of questions that are which you will be witnessing in your examination as far as your portfolio management topic is concerned. So you will get to know about all those concepts in this particular presentation. So are you guys excited to hear about this particular stuff? Let's mark the beginning of this presentation. That is the presentation number two for portfolio management. Fasten your seat belts. We're about to take off with the first topic of the day, and that will be with the return and risk. So guys, portfolio management's mool mantra: higher the amount of return that you expect to receive from the market, higher is the amount of risk that you should be ready and willing to take up in order to achieve that higher gain. So that was the mool mantra of it. But what do I mean by return on any of the security? So the basic thing that is used in any of the sphere, okay, you need to keep that thing in mind, that the kind of formula, the kind of concept that I made you understand while we were discussing topics like mutual fund, topics like dividend, that is something, that formula which I discussed with you back then will be like used in this particular chapter as well, because that is something which is not gonna be changing with different chapters. That was the mool formula, the main formula about any of the stuff. I basically don't say it as a formula, it's a very good concept, it's a very simple concept, but in a formula term, that will be very simple, which is the closing price on which you are selling your security. If your original price, the purchase price that you paid while purchasing that security, the differential between that two, okay, that will is the amount which you attained as profit. Cool, simple. Add to that any of your dividend which you have received all during that particular time. These are the only two things which you will receive in any of your return, as your return on any of your security. Number one is the capital growth, which is the closing price minus the opening price. Add to that the dividend, that is the income which you got all during that particular cycle time. Divide the same with the amount that you initially invested, the price that was available as your original purchase price. Simple, and you'll get your return on any of your security. So that is the basic formula, the basic concept relating to returns. Return on a security will be equal to P1 minus P0. Add to that dividend, divide the same whole with P0, where P1 is the price at the time of time 1, P0 is the price at time 0, and D is the dividend received during this period. Clear, guys? Simple? Fair enough? Wonderful. Next comes in your risk. What do I mean by risk? Risk is something which is divided into two segments. I will give you a basic idea of risk here itself, okay? Though I have, again, as beta and standard deviations are concerned, these are two different things, okay? I have got that detail wherein I'll be discussing with you about both of them in my forthcoming presentations as well. But then I need to give you the clarity here as well. So that risk on a particular security will be like basically divided into two segments. Number one is standard deviation, and number two will be beta. Standard deviation is something, guys, in which your entire risk, be it your systematic risk, be it your unsystematic risk, both of them, that total risk will be something which will be measured by your standard deviation. Standard deviation is the measure to say about your total risk. But when it comes to the systematic risk, the risk that is just not diversifiable in any of your way, okay, that is something which is systematic risk, okay? You cannot diversify it in any of your form, okay? You can't do anything about it. That is something which will happen to any of your security. So that is something which is being measured by beta. So herein, if I'm talking about risk here in this particular presentation slide, if I'm talking about risk, that will be only towards your standard deviation. The risk which is governing both your systematic risk as well as your unsystematic risk. Your total risk is being denoted by SD. And how do we get SD? Simple, guys. You need to use a formula which is summation of return on security less average return to the power 2, divide the same with n minus 1. Simple guys, whole root all that and you'll get your standard deviation. Why am I using this particular formula? Cool, simple guys, return on security is, let's say in a particular portfolio you got 5 securities, let's say A, B, C, D, and E. Okay, you got your average return on security A as 20%, on B as 30%, then on C as 40%, then again D and E as 30% and 20%. This is the individual returns, but what should be my average security return? What do I need to do it in order to get to that figure? Simple, I will sum up all these 5 returns and I'll divide it with 5. I'll get the average return if in case I'm investing into that particular complete portfolio. Simple guys, cool. I'll do that exercise 5 times, okay? That return on security less your average return. I'll do that again and again and again. Multiply the same to the power with 2 and whole divide with n, that is the number of times, which number of securities that is available in a portfolio. In our case, that was 5 minus 1, you'll get your denominator. And by this particular thing, you'll be able to get your standard deviation. Now, by doing this particular stuff, what do we really got? In this thing, you got that risk factor, that risk which will be like involving not just your systematic risk, but also your unsystematic risk. The one which is diversifiable and also the one which is non-diversifiable. Well, both of them you'll get in this particular stuff. And then you will be achieving that position wherein you can calculate your standard deviation. And if I'll talk about variance, variance is nothing but the standard deviation to the power of 2. That is something which is called as variance. Simple guys, that was all about your return and risk. Both these formulas will be like really imperative for you to retain in your mind, because you will be able to solve your questions only if in case you are thorough with your formulas and concepts at the right moment of time. So this will be used in our question series once we'll be starting that out. Next comes in another thing, which is coefficient of variation, then covariance and correlation coefficient. These are 3 different formulas. These are again the ones which you will have to retain in your mind. Next, let's mark the beginning with the first one, which is coefficient of variation. And don't worry, I'm not gonna be like leaving you like this. All these formulas along with example, I will make you solve this right here in this presentation. So don't even think about going ahead, okay guys? I'm not gonna leave you just like this. So you need to solve this question along with me in order to ensure and I make me believe that yes, you have understood this concept really well. So the first one is coefficient of variation. That will be equal to your standard deviation, divide the same with your expected return. So that was it about coefficient of variation. It will be calculated by dividing your standard deviation, that is your total risk, with your expected return. What amount of return is something which is expected from that investment. So that will be that will help you in calculating your coefficient of variation. Next comes in your covariance. So how do we calculate your covariance? Simple guys, summation of return on security 1. Let's suppose that is a hypothetical case, you will be investing in n number of securities. So your return on security 1 minus your average return on security 1, multiply it with return on security 2 with your average return on security 2. So herein, when I'm mentioning about security 1 and security 2, remember guys, I'm talking about a security or a portfolio in totality. So S1 is something which will be denoting to your security 1 and also your portfolio, your complete portfolio 1. So return on security 1 will be like divided into phases. Let's say you are investing 20% of your amount in one security. Number 2, you are investing, let's say 15% in another one. So what is the amount of average return that you will be taking up once you will be calculating it entirely on the portfolio basis? So that will be your average return. And if in case you are taking up that sole part one by one, that if in case there is a possibility of going ahead with 20%, then what will be the scenario? Deduct your average return out of that scenario. If in case you are going ahead with, let's say 15% of possibility, what will be your return on that scenario? deduct your average return on complete scenario from out of it. So this is how it will be like done. Summation of return on S1 minus average return on S1 multiplied by return on S2 minus average return on S2 whole divided by n minus 1. That will be your formula or concept for covariance. Lastly, it talks about the correlation coefficient. So what do we mean by correlation coefficient? It can be simply calculated by dividing your covariance that we just calculated one step ahead, divide it with your standard deviation of security 1 and standard deviation of security 2. Simple guys, that small p, that is not p, that is rho. Okay, like another alpha, beta, gamma, we have got another one which is rho. So wherein p1 by 12 herein, which is denoted like this, one rho is basically your correlation coefficient between the returns of stock 1 and 2. p1 by 2 is covariance between the returns on stock 1 and 2. And lastly, it's the standard deviation on stock 1 and stock 2. This was all about the correlation coefficient. However, in this particular presentation itself, I have also mentioned another formula which will be like seldom used out of the overall totality, but still that was something which was supposed to be like being shared with you guys. So that will be calculated once you'll be like multiplying your n, that is the number of securities, again this thing, summation of x1 and y1 minus summation of x1 multiplied by summation of y1, divide the same with whole under root of n summation x to the power of 2 for security 1 minus summation x1 to the power of 2, multiply it with n summation y to the power of 2 for security I, and finally deduct summation y1 square out of it. So I know it's a bit complicated. Again, that is the only reason why I'm telling you one thing, which is you need to retain it. Understand the concepts, because that is something really important for you. I am agreeing to that part, okay? But then you can't wait for this understanding or your complete concept part once you are entering the examination hall, okay? Because there you need to just have that formula in your mind, okay? Because that is going to be like saving your time completely. You can't memorize the entire concept and then come up with the formula, okay? That is going to be something which is going to be like taking huge amount of time. So going and revisiting the entire concept and then deriving the formula. So it's better to retain the formula in your mind, because that will help you in saving your time, and you can utilize that time on other questions as well. So this was all about coefficient of variation, covariance and correlation coefficient.